Hello, everybody. I'm Jonathan Coachman, and this is Super Bowl Sunday on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles as they take on Philip Rivers and the LA Chargers. Kickoff now just moments away. It is finally time to crown a champion as I'll hand it over to the two men who will call the action, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. Alongside my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. We are honored to be here for the biggest spectacle in sports, the Super Bowl. Are you ready, partner?
I am more than ready, and I love the word you used, honored, because it is an honor to be here. It's a privilege to be here. My excitement is just about to burst through the booth. I can't wait to do this.
Well, and sitting with both of these teams and talking in the meetings and media day and all the hoopla that goes into this, there was one common theme. They're ready to stop the talking and start playing football.
Yeah, they were probably ready a while ago. Now they can just focus on it. It's done. The only talking they have to worry about now is post-game, and they hope they'll be talking as the winning team.
And we'll see. You know, both sides come in with a game plan to start. We'll see how the adjustments are made throughout, because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try and take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
The first Super Bowl of the new decade, Super Bowl 54, is underway. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. There's Carson Wentz bringing out the Philadelphia Eagles. 21 touchdown passes, just 7 interceptions for him last year until a back injury knocked him out in Week 14. Two-time 1,000-yard rusher for the Bears. This is Jordan Howard. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. Here's the offense, and sometimes you got to show love to the big guys.
That you do. And we're talking about Jason Kelce now. Not Travis, his brother, who plays tight end. Jason lines up at center, a threat to go to the Pro Bowl each and every year.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Wentz now to throw, escaping the pressure right. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain. Here's Wentz to throw, and he connects with Ertz. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
I think this is going to be a free play. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Trevor Williams with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
On first down, Wentz. This short throw caught by Goddard. A gain of 6 there on first.
How about the timing on that one, where they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Looking to throw again on second down. Wentz, credit the sack to Joey Bosa. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sack.
Quarterback gets hit.
Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. From the gun, it's Wentz. He's got the hookup here to DeSean Jackson. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So on comes the Eagle kicker, Jake Elliott, on fourth down. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And the kick by Elliott is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So no problems at all on that one. And you know, there's virtually no win. This is a kicker's dream here tonight.
It absolutely is, isn't it? So to me, with no wind, it should be a passer's dream as well,
yeah.
Right? But in this case, the defense held out. He had to force the field goal.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Chargers' all-time passing leader, Phillip Rivers, who's been their starter since 2006, trotting onto the field. And I'll tell you what, he may be just a couple of years from 40, but he can still do it. You look back to 2018, some people were whispering MVP and Rivers in the same breath with what he did in that campaign. Especially impressive in two December primetime victories, one against the Steelers, one against the division rival Chiefs. And although things ended not quite how they wanted in the playoffs to New England, Phillip Rivers still feels like he has a lot left in the tank.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Throwing Rivers. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 6 TD. So a pick 6 there out of the nickel package. They went with 5 DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick 6 going the other way.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott.
He's got it, and now it's a 10-0 lead here in the opening quarter. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. So Rivers will lead the Chargers up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Melvin Gordon, the two-time Pro Bowler, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. With that, let's check out how the Chargers line up on offense.
I don't think it's hyperbole to say that Mike Pouncey is one of the best centers in the league, and to me, he helped usher in that new wave of centers. Agile, able to get to the second level and block people downfield, able to pull like a guard and get out in front of ball carriers, and pass protects really well. Cubs keep his quarterbacks clean.
On second and 7, Rivers on the right side, caught by Green.
And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
They have the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. From the gun, Rivers. He's got a man. It's Williams. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn: find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Rivers now. Across the formation, he's got a man. That's Allen. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Rivers now, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. Down right around the 25. Up to make the stop, the Pro Bowl safety, Malcolm Jenkins.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Only two there on the dump off. It's third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Here's Rivers, and he's got a man open. That's Allen. A Charger first down, Rivers hooking up with Allen. Well, this is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when, who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
A first red zone opportunity here for the Chargers. They come up first and 10 at the 16. Rivers to throw it. And Williams is in for a Charger touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Chargers are able to make this a close game again.
bouncing back nicely from that bad opening drive where he threw the interception. Drive number two leads him right down the field and into the end zone.
So obviously his confidence was never lost, and that's a good thing to see. Great quality to have, and you absolutely must maintain that as a quarterback. But I have to think that they're probably still on the script that they prepared for this game. Just the second drive, they've worked on these plays all week in practice. Put them to good use on that one.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best.
Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Joey Bosa, his second sack of the night.
How about that, partner? His second sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had 2 sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only 3 have had the record number of 3 sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16. Wentz. And an alley to run. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. Pretty nice gain on the scramble. Gets him 12 yards. From the gun on 3rd down, Wentz. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Second quarter action, 1:56 remaining. A reminder, coming up at intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Jonathan Coachman and the crew in Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
Rivers on 1st down. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they're marching off another 15 against your squad.
And now it's 1st and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Working out of the gun, Rivers. Allen's got it, over the middle. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. Now the Chargers hustling, trying to get up and get set to throw again on 2nd down. Rivers, Henry's got it, out on the left side. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
his position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league, those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little gain. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. And right side, Henry's got it. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. And the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Rivers now nearly perfect. 9 of 10 in this first half. It's first and 10. Now Rivers. And Green with a catch left side. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. They'll throw again. Rivers to Gordon, out left. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Give him three on the play, and they're going to face a third down. So five plays on this drive, Charles, all passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So on fourth down, on comes the Charger kicker, Michael Badgley. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. Badgley able to knock this one through. But wait up now, a flag is down. If this is on the defense, they're going to get the first. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the one. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. Shotgun now for Wentz. Flushed out right. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
A final shot before half for Wentz. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And that'll wind up incomplete. Try to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment.
We'll be right back.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The halftime show, quite a spectacle, but it's back to football for the second half of Super Bowl 53. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Now a pass here caught by Hunter Henry. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Operating from the gun, Rivers. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Give the sack to Fletcher Cox.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, five defensive backs. They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback never got rid of the football.
Now this one from about two counties over. After the sack, they come up on a second and very long. They'll give it to Gordon out of the shotgun. Nigel Bradham brings him down.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
It's complete, right side to Benjamin. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
On is the Chargers punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
A good run by Jordan Howard, and now another first and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa, make that now 4 sacks for him in tonight's ball game.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Now Wentz. They'll set up the screen to Howard. And he's got some space here. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A gain of 32 that time.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Wentz off the fake handoff to Howard. And this is Ertz with it, right side. That one goes for 24 yards.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Here we go. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. A give to Howard. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They go with Howard again. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion.
Let's go, boys.
One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. He's going to keep it. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. It's at this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
Wentz gonna throw to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
Howard all alone in the backfield on second and goal. Throwing his Wentz. Flush to his right. And he'll score! Touchdown, Eagles! A 5-yard touchdown run! And the Eagles have taken the lead. Not the first time on this drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
Oh, Davis from the top rope. I like it. Elliott now to add the extra point. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17-10. A 10-play drive that time, and it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Going up top. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now Rivers throw into the hands of Gordon, and he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain there, and it's going to bring up a third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. He got out of bounds. That's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up fourth down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a first down by getting out of your lanes, but you also don't want to just lay back and let them have it easily.
We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
A gain of 39 that time. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Now Wentz. And all this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. That goes for a gain of 31.
That was an excellent read right there. Saw cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there, and he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Throwing now is Wentz. Screen pass to Sproles. Nice gain of 8 that time, but it's second and goal.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
This is Howard on second down, and he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Jordan Howard taking it in, and the Eagles had 6 to their lead. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight-ahead power, and they got it done.
Elliott on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. So that drive, four plays. And finishing it off with a touchdown run was Jordan Howard. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Yeah, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Throwing again on second down, Rivers. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. The Chargers on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. Here it's third and 2. Rivers again. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. It'll be a pickup of 4. Good enough to earn him yet another first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores, want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Phillip Rivers, no stranger to fourth quarter comebacks. He's led the Chargers back to victory 26 times coming into this year. But work to do here if he wants to add another notch to the belt. Rivers on the money, complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They go play action here on first down. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
Try and get it all back with one big shot right there, but even if successful, that doesn't get them all the way back to where they need to be. Can't totally abandon throwing the ball underneath as well.
To throw again on second down. Rivers, nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sack back at the 29. Rivers, and the pressure gets to him again. Fletcher Cox, the former Mississippi State Bulldog, ringing the cowbell there on the sack. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham, and that will write a finish to this ball game. And the Lombardi Trophy will rest in the city of brotherly love. The Philadelphia Eagles are the Super Bowl champs. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness.
Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them. A fantastic season.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.